Hi, my name is Terry Jun with Magnanimous Media, and today we're going to be talking about some general post-workflow notes for the new Panasonic Varicam 35 4K cinema digital camera.
The Varicam camera actually uses Panasonic's general AVC intra codec. So actually, you can go ahead and start your program, such as Adobe Premiere, and I'll show you how easy it is to go ahead and ingest the footage. And you're probably familiar with this if you've done any editing before. So all you have to do is double click in your import area and hit import. So if you look over here in the project tab, you'll see the folder that came in, contents. Here are the various clips that were shot, and it has their own file naming conventions or clip naming conventions. And you can see the information, the time code information, as well as the frame rate. Well, if you know you're going to go ahead and edit in that native resolution of the clip, you can just go ahead and just drag it into a timeline, and it'll go ahead and create a sequence for you with the settings of that clip. And you're ready to edit. So let's get into color grading and see how well the AVC intra codec holds up. So just like in Adobe Premiere, bringing in the footage is really easy. We have the Varicam footage, and all you have to do is just go ahead and drop it down into the media pool. So here are all the clips being loaded up, and you're probably familiar with this from the editing session. Now what we have here is we shot in V-Log. So if you notice, it looks very flat. And a lot of directors, when, you know, if this is their first time seeing this type of image, they may be freaking out, but it's intentional. It's so that we can get the most latitude in post. Now, Panasonic, on their website, provides users to go ahead and download a lookup table that goes from their Varicam 35 V-Log profile to a what they're calling a V709, or their Rec 709 profile. So let me go ahead and just apply that. I already downloaded it, so we'll go ahead and apply that. And now you can see that the image is looking pretty already. So it gives you kind of a little baseline. So now let's look at some low light footage. As you can see here, we have some noise going on. That's to be expected. I'm going to go ahead and apply that 709 LUT. Now it gets really dark, so that kind of takes care of some of the noise there. So if we go ahead and, you know, push up the highlights and, you know, bring up the shadows, you know, now the noise is pretty evident there. Now, note again, you know, we're mentioning this again, this is not RAW. That you would need the Codex RAW recorder for the Panasonic to go ahead and record that, and you know, you would definitely have more latitude. But this isn't anything that you couldn't fix in post, and that's why you're pretty much shooting in this format and profile. So DaVinci has a pretty good noise reduction, and it does a really good job, and you can see here it does clean up a lot of the noise.
Thanks again for watching our video. We hope that it was informative in your future decision making. If you have any other questions regarding any camera gear or the Panasonic 4K 35mm digital cinema camera, feel free to contact us at magnanimous.biz.